Esteemed judges, ladies, gentlemen, and my dear friends. Actor Charlie Chaplin once said, "Even when I was in the orphanage, when I was roaming the streets, trying to find enough to eat, even then I thought of myself as the greatest actor in the world." You had to feel the exuberance that comes from utter confidence in yourself. Without it, you go down to defeat. When I'm standing here to talk to you about the topic, "Our minds can overcome our limitations," this quote from a man who overcame great difficulties in life to become a legend in the film industry is an example to show how such great men use their minds to overcome their limitations. Yes, our mind is the most powerful thing we have. If we believe we can do something, we will. But if we believe we can't, we most probably won't. Helen Keller, who was born deaf and blind, won over a near complete lack of language and learned to communicate, finally earning a Bachelor of Arts degree. She went on to become one of the best American authors and political activists, and is a great example of the human mind's potential power to overcome our physical limitations. Sudha Chandran, the Indian dancer who lost one leg in an accident, has subsequently overcome her disability with the help of a prosthetic Jaipur foot, becoming one of the most highly acclaimed dancers of the Indian subcontinent. Oscar Pistorius, the South African sprint runner, although in the news recently for a different reason, was another great example of great men overcoming their limitations with just the power of their minds. Both of Pistorius' legs were amputated below the knee when he was just 11 months old. Yet he went on to win gold medals, even in the real Olympics, competing against other able-bodied athletes, wearing his metallic legs. The list goes on and on. One of the greatest music composers of all time, Ludwig van Beethoven. One of the greatest presidents the US has ever seen, Franklin D. Roosevelt. One of the greatest singers in American history, Stevie Wonder. They all prove that humans can overcome any limitations set upon them with their strong willpower and determination. Now, there's another major factor to think about when we discuss the mind's power to overcome our limitations. Booker T. Washington was an African-American born into slavery, but he overcame that limitation to become a famous educator, author, and political advisor to Republican presidents. He once said, "Success is to be measured not so much by the position that one has reached in life as by the obstacles which he has overcome." So we have to understand that it is difficult to compare the successes of different humans since everyone goes through different kinds of struggles in their lives. However, one thing is certain: the future that we envision is most probably the future that we help create. So let's always be optimistic and hopeful, and let our positive attitude enable us and all around us to become the best we could ever be in our lives. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. By a show of hands, how many of you have heard of Harry Potter? Okay. So a fair amount of you. How many of you have heard of J.K. Rowling? Well, I bet some of you haven't. Let me tell you who she is. She is the woman that created the legend of a boy who grew up to destroy Lord Voldemort. She is the woman behind the magic at Hogwarts, witchcraft, and wizardry. She is the woman who created Harry Potter. She is J.K. Rowling. Joanne Kathleen Rowling, or Jo as she was called, was born July 1965 in England. And as a girl, she grew up in the time where there was an epidemic of poverty. She had four jobs at the age of 10, and she struggled. Then, after earning some hard-earned money, she went to college. She applied to Oxford, but they didn't let her in. So she applied to the College in London, Exeter University. After earning her French and Classics degree, she worked as a bilingual researcher for Amnesty International. And then she settled down and got married. Then, this is my favorite part of the story, the first event of magic happened. On a small little train from Manchester to London's King's Cross Station, which many of you might know is where Harry Potter travels to school every year. And who would have ever thought that the world phenomenon Harry Potter was being written on that train? Then times got tough. She got divorced. She was living at the verge of poverty. She could barely put food on the table. And then she saw a light. At first, it was only considered a hobby. And then it became more than that. It became a need of survival. Harry Potter. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone was born. It was rejected many times by Portugal publishers. Then Children's House Clearing decided to publish her work. They were amazed by her work and talent. And on July 1991, Harry Potter was born. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, you might think. No, it's Sorcerer's Stone, right? Well, they originally changed the name because it was a mouthful. Wouldn't you think so? And then, after that, she settled down. Then the movie came out. Now, the movie came out in 2001. It was top charts in UK, Japan, Australia, you name it. Everybody was watching it, and everybody loved the idea of Harry Potter. So, my friends, J.K. Rowling is not only my favorite author, but my inspiration. And I love her as an author. So, this is why J.K. Rowling is my favorite author. Thank you.
For noble achievement is called greatness. And littleness is a thought that says, I shall live without it, says the great Tamil poet, Thiruvalluvar, in his work, Thirukkural. Judges, guests, and fellow speakers, as the poet aptly describes, the most important step into overcoming limitations is the sustained desire to do so. People may use different ways, but what I do is train my mind to maintain an optimistic attitude that translates into successful results. Using our mind to overcome limitations just does not mean having a positive attitude. Rather, it is an experience earned by overcoming obstacles. No way can you merely hope that nice things will happen at the end. Hope is a good feeling, but not a strategy. To succeed, we should know the realities of the problem, and that knowledge will help us to strategize our plan of action. Let me give you a recent example of what happened to me at a family function. I had traveled to Kerala to attend my uncle's wedding and reached there just 3 days before. That evening, we found out that the person who had agreed to be the master of ceremony for the wedding reception could not come. Nobody else was prepared to do the job. I was very timid at first to take up the challenge, but I also realized that it presented me with a many-sided opportunity. First, to help out the family, and secondly, a chance for myself to overcome my fear of public speaking. I had to first create the self-expectation that I'm going to do it and do it well. This expectation of victory triggered the much-needed self-confidence. I knew I had several obstacles to overcome, like scripting and presenting confidently. Scripting was fairly easy, but my first setback came with the first rehearsal. I was nervous. I had problems pronouncing the family names and the names of the ceremony. But I worked through the practice session, and my presentation turned out to be quite impressive. This is just a personal story from my side, but much more can be learned from the lives of Beethoven, Helen Keller, and others, who with their conquering spirits overcame serious disabilities. Do you think the human race would have stood a chance without using its mental capability? The human civilization went through famines, diseases, and acts of terror, but it still prevailed through the marvelous acts of noble people and through advances in science and technology. It is easy to find disheartening realities all around you, but as a young child, I have to choose hope over fear, unity of purpose over conflict. I feel that it is my responsibility to advance in that rightful path and never allow any limitations to overcome my God-given defined spirit. Thank you, and God bless.